Be very careful if you enter very long numbers in Excel, especially if you actually mean them to not be a number. So for example here, can you see I've got a very long number here? It's got 20 characters. The only way I've managed to achieve this is because I've put an apostrophe in front of it. If I entered it normally, Excel would do something like this. It'll give us exponential. But if you look carefully, when you format that as a number, which is over here, notice that the last four characters are different. So up to there, it registers. But once it gets to this bigger number, Excel can't handle it, and so it just puts zeros here. So you've got to be very careful. And this even happens, notice here, if I plus one to it. Just to emphasize it further, you'll see that is as far as it can go. So if I went in here and I changed that to a two, no problem. But if I go into this one and I change this last one to a two, notice it reverts back to zero, even where I've typed it in. So let's go to this one here. We'll change these last three to twos. Again, it changes it to zeros, even though I typed it in there. So if you have very long numbers like this, then very rarely actual numbers you plan to add together. So you need to capture them with an apostrophe in front so that they actually maintain the integrity of the number.